alcohol every day. 1 ounce in the morning, 1 ounce at night. This woman came down and died. She didn't die. Because Julio went out there, the third way of healing is for him to look at his plants, talk to his genios, talk to his genies, and say, I'm the maestro of all you. I've come to teach you. I own you. You own me because I own you. Give me what you got. What does she need? And they did. He sent his son out to collect the plants the next day. He made a concoction for her. She drank it against her will. About half an ounce in the morning, half an ounce at night. And she began to call me every 6 months. Hello, Peter. You know, you suck. I really hate the fucking trip. It was really the worst trip in the whole world. I'm the Swiss Alps driving around on motorcycles right now. 6 months later, not Peter. You know, I'm in Russia right now, and I'm skiing. I'm not dead yet, but it's not your fault. She called me 6 months, 6 months, 6 months. She lived 7, 8 years. I don't know how many years she lived. She's probably still alive right now, but she's certainly got 4 or 5 years, more than her 2 weeks. That's just the third way of healing, using the plants, going up there to access the information from the plants. You know? The fourth way of healing is for ayahuasca to use you yourself. For ayahuasca to send little doctors, or ayahuasca to send whatever you want to call them, and those of you who drank enough ayahuasca know what I'm talking about. They send their little guys down to do the work on you. Clean you. And that's a very, very direct and very harsh way of it. You know, here we are. We're here to clean you. No, I'm just kidding. I was talking to my friends last week. Come on, you're here to heal me. They tear you to pieces. And they rip you up and tear you apart. And that's another way I was to heal. In my world, when my marriage, the most beautiful woman, the most loving, fun woman in the world, nobody was happy to be in married to a woman from down here 20 years ago. And when she broke up with me, just tore me apart. So I lost 5 years coming back over and over and over and ripping me up, you know, live with it. A part of that, this leads into ayahuasca's work to clean you, or to fix you, via vomiting. Vomiting is the most wonderful, freaking thing in the world with ayahuasca. You slow motion see all your sins. I don't know about you guys, but for me. You broke up with a girl when you were 14 years old, and you lied to her. You said, I'm not dating Betsy. She's your best friend. I would never tongue kiss her. No damn well, you can come kiss her every goddamn chance you got. Ayahuasca is going to make you live that 1,000 times. Slow motion. There you are kissing Betsy. There you are lying to Jeannie. There you are kissing Betsy. There you are lying to you. Until finally it's like, boom, it comes out of you. You can let it go. You don't need to carry that around anymore. Carry the memory. Don't commit the same sin. Live the sin 1,000 times and then let it go. But it wasn't sin. Change. Don't do that again. That's healing. That's real. That's healing in the soul. This is important stuff. For some of you who drank ayahuasca 300 times, these are old stories and you already know them. For some of you who didn't drink 1,000 times or 100 times or 20 times, these are important things to remember. Ayahuasca can heal you. For the day, it was important. Drinking alone is not the same as dealing with the port of the day. Who could say, you, up, you, down, sit in the corner. You'll be too loud for a fucking half hour. For the day, it was a lot of work. The healing comes 4, 5, 6, 10 different ways. You know, it could be direct, it could be indirect, it could be from the port of the day, it could be from the plant. Can be all sorts of ways. The point is, what we want, what ayahuasca wants, what ayahuasca wants, ayahuasca, you cleaner tomorrow than you were today. She wants you polished up. If you're already a wonderful human being, she wants you to gleam like a gold bracelet that somebody just polished. I don't know why she wants that, but she wants it. Somehow it's important to this world that you're a little bit better tomorrow than you were yesterday by a lesson. She's got the juice to do it, and she wants to give it to you. If you're sick, she wants to heal you. Bruce Springsteen saw you. Hey, man, I'm sick. She said, baby, let me heal you. Boom. She wants to heal you. Don't fight. When you drink, don't fight. Let go. Get healed. Get clean. As clean as you are. If you're already a shining star, polish up at night. She's got a million ways to do it. All of them painful. All of them painful. Because this is the jungle. And nothing here comes easy. Many of you think something came here easy. You're not in the jungle. You're sitting in the Iquitos. You're not in the jungle. In the jungle, everything's coming. You pay everything. Pay with your heart, you pay with your soul, you pay with everything you've got. You deal with it. Then you come out of that. And that's what I had to say. So now it's time for questions. So they asked me about navigational tips or whatever. Yeah? There are three ways, the three simplest ways to navigate. One, see this wall right here? Turn around. Just look at that wall for 1 second. That's the wall of an apartment building. When we drink ayahuasca, we rip that frickin' back wall off. There are 300 families living there. We are peeking in on those 300 families. You know what? They're looking back and I say, who the frick is looking at us? I'm taking a shower, I'm having coffee, I'm on the phone, whatever they're doing. Those are called looky-loos. My looky-loos. They're looking at us. Like we're going to the spirit world. The spirits are looking back. Where did you come from? If they bother you when you drink ayahuasca and you have to compartmentalize and your brain will explode, they'll turn up as clowns, monkeys, friends, enemies, monsters, whatever. Because we don't know what spirits look like. So we put faces to them so our brain just doesn't overheat or boil over. When you drink ayahuasca, you see all the looky-loos looking back at you, but they're surprised that the wall came down. If you don't like what you see, look at this. I don't care if you do it out loud or in your soul, whatever. Blow it away. They'll disappear. Now, if they don't disappear, they might very well be a teacher of yours. So you might ask the question, oh, I thought you were going away. I thought you're not going away. You're a teacher of mine. And if they die, like, whatever. Ask them the question, real simple. What do you have to teach me? Chances are, they'll say something like, and start walking and come with me. Come with me, I'll teach you. You know what? Here's the thing. And I think almost nobody is going to know this. Because if you weren't at the Indian camps 30 years ago, you won't know this. Everything here is fierce and ferocious. The word is brava. Brava. You go to the Indian camp, there's three guys in the camp with 9 wives, 40 children. Pull up in a canoe. They're firing everything they have. They're killing you before you get there. Because you can't mean anything good. Nobody ever came and give them stuff. They come and take stuff. They've learned that, so they're firing arrows at you. Blow guns. They're tough. They have to protect their turf. There's only 3 men. There might be 50 people, but it's 3 men. Everybody else is king of life. The spirits are the same way. When you run into somebody who's a teacher in ayahuasca, I would say, almost never will they say, almost never will they say, yes, teacher, look, fairy dust. And from now on, you can see in the dark. And it's easy. No, it's usually, watch this. And your face explodes. You're like, what the freak? I'm scared to death. Yeah. Because if you're not as tough as that, you don't get it. You have no right. It's like fighting an Irishman in 1955 in Liberty City. Want to play basketball? Take an elbow to the head 3 or 4 times, and then give an elbow to the head. Now we're in fair record. If you're that tough, they'll give you what they got to give you. But those spirits, those real spirits, had their own lives and their own agendas. And suddenly, some reason, freaking ayahuasca saved themselves. They have no reason. Why? It's Tuesday. That's going to be a better teach this fucking up on a white knife for what? So they're going to make it tough. You have to be as tough as them. You see a monster in ayahuasca that's 100 feet tall. And who didn't tell me this for like 25 years? Make yourself 300 feet tall and squash it. You see somebody that bites your head off, pull his head off, and eat it. Then he said, oh, dude. Here's what I'm going to teach you. This is how to be happy with everyday life. This is how to make a living for the rest of your life without a sweat. This is how to be nice to people. This is how to share things with people. But normally they're using yourself to share. They'll teach you everything you need to know. But they're robbed. The jungle's robbed. All the medicines here are tough and hard. I saw sap from a couple of people the other night over here. They wanted sap, and I would come to my room, and I would pay $50, and I would pay $5 in the room. Fine, you see. Boom, boom, boom. Well, I feel. And people go, yes, it's tough. Work and pain. Just like I lost the work and pain. It's not easy. Never going to be easy. It's the jungle everything's hard. You want to learn from a teacher? Are you my teacher? You only have a split second to make that decision. That teacher's business. He's got his own life. They don't need you. They were only asked by that one. Teach them something. Teach them with disability. Teach them love. Teach them compassion. Teach them decency. Teach them how to share. Whatever. You only got 1 second to follow that person. If you're afraid or back off,